Okay, ASA is also known as Adaptive Security Appliance. So where do we need firewalls, or what is the use of firewall in network protection? Okay, so basically if we talk about routers or switch, so you send any packets, they will send across to someone else. Okay, so there is no blocking happening on router and switches until we apply some access list. Okay, when we talk about firewalls, by default all are blocked. Okay, all the traffics are blocked. So which is that traffic that will actually be passed to the other network? Okay, so basically if I put access list for permit, so only those traffics are getting passed, rest all are dropped. Okay, so basically the working of a router switch and a firewall is completely different. In router and switch, everything is permitted. We can deny or we can drop some traffic with the help of access list. In case of firewall, all are dropped. Okay, all the things are dropped by default. All the traffic communication is dropped. By default, router and switch will permit all the traffic, but we can block some traffic on the basis of access list. If I define access list to drop some traffic, I can write that and I can drop that traffic. But by default, the nature is to permit all the traffic. Whereas in firewall, by default, everything is dropped. Okay, you don't even need to have access list. By default, it is dropping everything. Now, in order to pass our traffic, I am going to write access list with permit statement. Okay, do you see the difference? I am writing here access list to permit the connection. Okay, so that firewall can allow that traffic. Whereas in the previous case, we were denying the packets. Okay, they are two different things. How do they look like? So basically, the ASA firewall look very similar to your router and switch. Okay. So if you go and search for ASA firewall, so this is how your ASA firewall looks like. Okay, it's kind of a box piece. See, it's very similar to your normal router and switches. See, this is 5525. Okay. So let's talk about a few history or a few background about ASA firewall, like when ASA was launched in the market. What was the purpose of ASA? Was there any other devices before ASA firewall? Okay. So basically, Cisco ASA firewall is very older technology or very old hardware, piece of hardware, which was launched in, say, somewhere in 1990s. Okay, so before Cisco ASA, we had something called Cisco PIX. So this was a firewall which was launched before ASA firewall. Say you can say like in 86 to 1994, Cisco PIX was in the market. Later on, due to the limitations, we were introduced with Cisco ASA firewall. Okay, so I can say from 1994 even till now, Cisco is continuously launching this product. The IOS are the software. Okay, I'm talking about software and hardware. So software, the hardware are continuously getting updated. Okay, they're still running in the market. Whereas this one was declared as end of life in 1994, and then they launched the new product called Cisco ASA Firewall. So that doesn't end the firewall progress with Cisco company. Okay, Cisco, what it did is, when there was a market like after 2012 onwards, when market was launching new firewall products, which was called as next generation firewall product like Palo Alto, right? You had Checkpoint. Checkpoint is pretty old, but it is also one of the next generation firewall. You have FortiGate, right? So when the market was seen booming for these product, now Cisco made a next step, and the next step is Cisco launched something called Cisco Next Generation Firewall. Okay, so this next generation firewall can be a good competitor with these other firewall product in the market. Okay, but ASA firewall is very simplest. It is very economical, low cost device, which is very good for a mid-size companies. Okay, there are always debate going on, like whether should I go with ASA firewall or should I go with Palo Alto, Checkpoint, or FortiGate. So see, when you are raising these questions, you should talk about the segment you're looking for. Okay, there are multiple segment in a market. Some are this small size segment where you have 5 to 10 employees, right? You have mid-size segment where you have like 100 of employees in one office. You have a large enterprise where you talk about in 1,000 of employees, right? So when we talk about mid-size segment, okay, with like 5 to 20 employees, why do you want to spend so much of money on Palo Alto, Checkpoint, FortiGate, which will easily cost up to 2 to 4 lakhs? Okay, so if you talk about in US dollar, it should come closer to like 10,000 to $20,000. So that is really expensive when we talk for 50 to 20 employees, right? So most of people have this concern that why ASA doesn't do all the functionality of these next generation firewall. Palo Alto is much superior. But you should also talk in terms of the segment also, right? You cannot place for Palo Alto for 50 to 20 employees by spending $20,000 for an year, right? So you have to think about the cost also. So Cisco ASA firewall, I don't say Cisco ASA firewall is very powerful or it is equivalent to these next generation firewall. That is why Cisco launched something called Cisco Next Generation Firewall, which where you have firepower coming into picture. Firepower, we have fire threat defense. Okay, so you should understand the background of every firewall before you enter into discussion or arguments or debate. Okay, you cannot be so blind enough that you support one firewall. Might be that firewall is in your office or you are using that firewall and you say that we are making use of Palo Alto and Palo Alto has that feature, Palo Alto has this feature, we can do that, we can do. But ASA, you should talk, even you should know the background of every areas. Okay, just talking on firewall level doesn't answer it. You should understand where is this firewall getting deployed. Okay, that also matters. So when we talk about the mid-size segment, or say a average or a medium-size segment with 100 to 200 users, okay, so ASA hold good enough. The ASA firewall gets the job done easily. Okay. And the cost of support, the iOS upgradation, the advanced services, everything will not even cost you like more than say $5,000. Okay, so which is really a small amount when compared with other devices, right? So what is difference between this device and these next generation devices? Okay, so let me mention is mention by making two columns. Let me say this as a legacy device because it's an older device. It's not a next generation device. So I'm going to say Cisco ASA is a legacy device. And then comes your next generation firewall, which I can write as next gen firewalls. Okay. So what all firewalls we have? We have Cisco FTD. We have Palo Alto. We have FortiGate. We have Checkpoint. Okay. So the first difference, this was launched in 1994, whereas all this started coming after 2000 or 2001 or 2010. Some are even like 2012 they were launched. Okay. So I can say there is a huge difference even in terms of the launching date and year. Okay. So basically this was launched in 1990s. Which after 10 to 15 years, all your next generation firewall started launching. Okay. So you can never compare ASA firewall with a next generation firewall. That would be the biggest mistake you are doing in your network career. Okay. So never compare ASA firewall with next gen firewalls. You can, yes, compare a FTD with Palo Alto, might be FortiGate and Checkpoint. So they are next generation firewall. You can compare between them, but not with ASA firewall. Okay. ASA firewall is designed for mid segment. It's not defined or it is not designed for a very large enterprise level. Okay. It's a mid-range segment, or also we can call it as an average range or a medium range segment. Okay, where the user capability is up to 200 to 300. Okay, say 1 to 200 users. So we can make use of ASA firewall. Now, if I have more than 300 of users, then I can go with the next gen firewall.